Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. Rabbi shahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa ahlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Subhanak la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana. Subhanak la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana. Subhanak la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana. Amma ba'd. Very auspicious occasion. Last half hour, 45 minutes before Salatul Maghrib, before Iftar on a blessed day of Jumu'ah in the midst of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our sitting here and listening and speaking. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this weighty in our scales. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow all of us to be able to practice in all that we share. And all that we hear and all that we speak. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save any of this to becoming a proof against us on the Day of Judgment. For us, intentionally or out of our own nafs and desire, not practicing on the teachings that we are sharing. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this as a, make it as we are seeking ilm. Not just listening to a talk, but instead may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala judge us as though we are all students of knowledge, seeking ilm in the midst of Ramadan, in the midst of our jobs, in the midst of all the obligations we have that are home. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise us from amongst these tulab al-ilm, all of us. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. The last paragraph that we covered yesterday was, do not be content to wait for good to come to you. Try to avoid being the center of attention. Constantly thank Allah and seek His forgiveness abundantly. Reflect on your thoughts and prepare for tribulations with sound knowledge. Preparing for tribulations with sound knowledge. And we move on to the second paragraph after that. He says, وَعَلَيْكَ بِالتَّأَنِّي عِنْدَ مَوَارِدِ الْعَجَلَةِ وَحُسْنِ الْأَدَبِ فِي الْمُخَالَطَةِ ولا تغضب لنفسك على الناس واغضب لله على نفسك ولا تكافئن أحدا بإساءة واحذر المدحة للجاهل بنفسه ولا تقبلها لنفسك من أحد وأقلل الضحك وأقلل الضحك وجانب المزاحة. It says Imam Muhasibi rahimahullah in the book of, in his book رسالة المسترشدين is saying وَعَلَيْكَ بِالتَّأَنِّي عِنْدَ مَوَارِدِ الْعَجْلَةِ. Be deliberate in those situations that seem to demand haste. All of the situations which demand haste, which people want to ask you to make a quick decision, those type of situations, make sure you do not rush into giving an answer. Make sure you do not rush into making a decision. Instead, make sure you take your time. Be deliberate in those situations that seem to demand haste. Very interesting piece of advice. We live in a very fast-paced world, of course, and people are always wanting to want everything quick. Download speeds have to be quick. 5G and microwavable dinners, as they say, right? All these things. So in that environment, in the text message, you see there was a good old time when we have make phone calls and house phone, and you leave a voicemail. Answering machine, I remember the first time that we got one, that was a big thing. Like, oh wow, you actually can find out who called you. First time we found *67 caller ID call back, that was such an amazing thing in the early 90s. Like, you could actually find out who called you. Otherwise, you wouldn't know who called you. It was just, they keep on calling, and eventually you came back home and picked it up. You spoke to them, otherwise you wouldn't know who called, right? That was just life in the 90s, in the 80s, and before that as well. So this whole answering machine system and the caller ID system, the callback system, and then, you know, the voicemail system, all sorts of, then the cordless phone system, all these things have evolved into then the mobile sets and the Nokias and the Ericssons to where we are now, with instant messaging, with WhatsApp, with text. And what has happened here is that we live in a time that if you've seen that I've sent a message, I'm expecting an answer immediately. It wasn't like that before, right? If I pick up the phone and I say I got this proposal, half of the time you're not going to pick it up. Eventually, when you do pick it up, you're like, okay, you know what? Let me sleep over it. I'll call you back tomorrow. But now that doesn't work today. It seems that we're all part of the problem. We send a text, we want immediate response. And we want the decision to be made right now. I'm part of the problem. This is the environment we live in. So sometimes people are demanding from us that you need to quickly say, are you going to go? Yes or no? You're going to do this or no? So don't worry about the situation. You have to make sure that you're making the right decision. And so we have a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam where he said that it is al-ajalatu min ash-shaytan wal ana'atu min Allah. Right? That hurriedly doing things, this is from shaitan. And ana'a min Allah, to deliberately think about something and to ponder about something and to do it in a proper manner, that's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ta'anni or ana'a. And there was an incident when Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was sitting in his masjid, and Ashaj ibn Abd al-Qais, who was the leader of the tribe of Abd al-Qais, they came to meet him. And so everyone came running in. Imagine how you feel when you go to Medina. May Allah open up the doors for all of us. How you feel when you see the green dome coming from the airport. And some of us sometimes when we're landing, depending on where you're landing from in the time of the day or night, you can actually see the Masjid an-Nabawi from the airplane. But there's just something about that, most definitely. How about seeing the minarets of Makkah al-Mukarramah, Masjid al-Haram, as you're going through the winding streets of Makkah and you're falling asleep coming from Medina or from the airport, you're so tired in your ihram. And you hear, you know, all the nasheeds going on in the back, or labbaik, talbiyah taking place, and half open your eyes and you see your eyes fall upon the minaret of Masjid al-Haram. What does it do to you? Imagine the excitement, and you want to run, but you can't. The bus is going to go to the hotel first. You have to wait. You have to take all the luggage. It's going to go to the bottom ground floor. Then eventually they're going to take it to your lobby. Then your travel agent is going to give you your room number. And you know, it takes a good solid another hour. Subhanallah. So imagine these people. They're not looking at a dome, the green dome. They're not looking at the minaret. They are outside the simple, humble masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which he built with his own hands. And guess what? Inside the masjid is the man, the person himself, the personality of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sitting there in the masjid. And they have come from far. They have come very far to come see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And in this situation, imagine how, after traveling through desert for months, how would you feel that you're about to come face to face with the most beloved face on earth, the most beloved face under the sun, the face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And so the Abd al-Qais, they ran into the masjid, just too excited. However, the leader of the tribe, he stayed back. And Ashaj Abd al-Qais, he sat and tied the camels, took care of the camels, tying them up, probably giving them water, all that stuff. And then he entered the masjid behind everyone else afterwards. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at him and said, "Inna fika khaslatain yuhibbuhumullah." Indeed, you've got two attributes, two qualities that Allah loves. Not only I like it, but Allah loves it. And what is that? Al-hilm, you are forbearing. He saw what type of people he had to be a leader of. Imagine how they he had to handle all of their problems throughout the journey and back in their own tribe. It's tough being a tribal leader. So you've got forbearance. And number two, al-ana'a. You've got deliverance. And you take your time. in doing things. So he said, "You, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, praised him." So basically, what is the hadith, the aspect of doing things hurriedly is something from shaitan. What does it mean, something from shaitan? It means that shaitan wants us sometimes to make decisions, right? Shaitan wants us to do things hurriedly . In reality, they're harmful for us, but he wants us to do it. And in that hurried situation, we end up paying the price. A person is angry and he ends up doing something. Could be anything. Could be pulling the trigger. Could be picking up a knife, wielding a weapon. Could be all these are horrible situations. Could be divorcing his wife. Right? All of these things. What happened? He jumped while in the state of being angry, and he did not deliberate over what he should be doing. So the purpose of shaitan is to make you bite your lip, bite your fingernails, bite your finger, bite your hand. That's what he wants. He wants you to feel guilty. He wants you to feel bad about the decision you have made. So that's why he pushes you towards that. That's what this hadith means. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, this is a huge topic. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that يُسْتَجَابُ لِلْعَبْدِ مَا لَمْ يَسْتَعْجِلْ. A servant's du'as are accepted as long as he doesn't hurry. As long as he is not impatient. Keep on making du'a every day at iftar, every day at suhoor, every day during the day after salah. Every day you feel thirsty, hungry, angry, frustrated, you're in pain, and while you're fasting, make dua. Not today, tomorrow. Not tomorrow, the day after. Sooner or later, your dua will get accepted. But do not say, I've been making dua for already 15 days, nothing has happened. I've been making dua for so many years, it hasn't happened. That doesn't help your cause. That just makes things even worse for you or for me or anyone else who says that. So this is something that shaitan does. He makes you impatient. Why is your things not getting accepted? Why is your da'a not getting accepted? Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. So the opposite of this, some people say, but what about khair, works of khair? Should we not hurry up in that? Are we supposed to deliberate? All the time we've been hearing, سارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم ففي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون بادروا بالأعمال سبعة بادروا بالأعمال فتنة. All of this hadith and Quranic ayats that we share, which tell us to hurry up and do work. Hurry up and do good deeds. Don't waste your time. What about that? So this is what it is. When it comes to the a'mal of akhirah, then don't think. Jump. When you have an opportunity to donate a dollar, do it. When you have an opportunity to feed someone, do it. When you have an opportunity to recite some Quran, do some dhikr, don't overthink. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu is reported to have said, لا يتم المعروف إلا بتعجيله فإنه إذا عجله هنأه. He says that good deeds don't happen unless you do it hurriedly. Any good deeds, they don't stick around for anyone. You have to jump on it. When you jump on it and you hurriedly do it, doesn't mean you, while you're doing it, you rush through it, but you rush to do it, then you will enjoy the glad tidings of that deed. So this is something which the Quran is asking us to do. فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. Run towards good deeds. يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. They compete with one another toward the good deeds. سَارِعُوا لَمَغْفِرَةٍ. Run towards the forgiveness of Allah. Right? All of these aspects are in its place. They do not go against the hadith al-ajalat min shaitan, that being rushed comes from shaitan. It is mentioned that one of the pious people, he was in his restroom. He called his servant from the restroom and he said, I want you to go quickly give sadaqah. Such and such person, go in the street, go to the neighbor, give sadaqah. And he told him, after the servant said, my dear elder, هَلَّا صَبَرْتَ حَتَّى تَخْرُجْ مِنْ الْخَلَاءِ. Why didn't you just wait until you come out of the bathroom? Until you come out of the restroom? So he said, حَضَرَتْنِي هَذِهِ النِّيَّةِ فَأَحْبَبْتُ التَّعْجِيلَ بِهَا. This niyyah came to me, and I didn't want this niyyah to change. وَلَا آمَنُ عَلَى نَفْسِي التَّغَيُّرِ. And I can't be sure, I can't say for sure that this niyya of mine will not change. I can't say that. Dear brothers and sisters, think about these words. I don't know about you, but this really, really hits me. Because I have definitely been there in a situation where I wanted to do something and there was a delay. I couldn't have, let's say, sadaqah or something. I didn't have my wallet or didn't have my phone with me to be able to do something. And when that time goes away, the niyyah also, you forget about the niyyah. And days later you forget. You said, oh, I thought I was going to give that person some hadiyah. I was going to donate to someone, such and such. I was going to help someone who was in need. But that niyyah is gone. Now, if you remember, you can do it, but many times you don't remember it. There's another similar story like this mentioned of a businessman or a seyyid or a master. He was going through the marketplace and a beggar came to him begging. He said, please give me something. Just give me your shirt. Give me anything. The businessman, while walking, and his servant is behind him, he took his shirt out and he told the servant, give it to him. The servant said, are you sure, master? He said, yes, do it. So he took his shirt off, gave it to him, and the beggar went away. The servant was quiet until they arrived home. He asked the master, Master, may I ask, why did you do that? You walked through the marketplace bare-chested. This beggar had nothing to do. He could have walked with us home. You could have gone inside and give him the shirt and taken another shirt. You could have given him, if you really wanted to give him a shirt, you could have done so. But why did you do it in the middle of the marketplace? He could have followed you home. And he said, I wasn't sure if I told him to follow me home, whether when I arrive at home, would I still feel the desire to give. So, dear brothers and sisters, in terms of ibadah, in terms of deen, let's not delay. Hanaf ibn Qais one day was sitting with Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan. And Muawiyah radiallahu anhu said, nothing compares to deliberation. Nothing is comparable to doing things, you know, after pondering and thinking it out. Ahnaf said, illa fi thalath. He said, no, there are certain things you should not wait. And what is that? He said, tabadir bil amal salih. Tabadir bil amal salih ajalaka. Make sure you do good deeds before death comes to you. We cannot wait when it comes to do good deeds. Another hadith the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, Imam Ghazali mentions from Hatim al-Sam, that from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is itamu ta'am, feeding people. Don't delay in that. Tajiz al-mayyit, burying the deceased. Don't delay in that. Tazweej al-bikr, in getting an unmarried person married. Don't delay in that. Qada' al-dayn, fulfilling a debt. Don't delay in that. Wa tawbatu min al-dhanb, and repenting from a sin. Don't delay in that. So these are things that we need to hurry up in. But in terms of other aspects, then it's good to think things out well. And that was the advice we started off from, right? Properly thinking about things. That's why, my dear brothers, may Allah open up the doors of the masjid and the public places soon, and may Allah remove this epidemic. But when, you know, how many times we've attended a fundraising dinner in a masjid or a banquet hall, and you and I felt like we need to give. We thought, I'm sure all of you can think of a moment like that, we want to give. And we said, we'll give it. And we said, we'll give it at the end when you go to smaller dollar amounts. And then we'll give it during dinner time. Okay, we'll give it on the way out. And subhanAllah, we left the dinner without giving. Even though we were so motivated when the speeches were going on that we wanted to give. That's a huge mahrumiyah. That's what we're speaking about. And then we'll say, okay, fine, I'll send it afterwards. Let me go to their website. That doesn't happen. For most people, that doesn't happen. For most people, that does not happen. So I pray to Allah that He opens up the doors for us again, that we can meet and congregate. But I want to remind myself and all of us that when this opportunity comes for any good deed, do not delay. This is from Shaytan. I heard from some pious people before that a good intention is a gift from Allah. If you do not respect a good intention by following through and fulfilling the good intention, then this gift will not come back. Just like a guest does not come back to anyone, similarly a good intention is a guest from Allah who, when not honored, will decide not to knock on your door again. So these are good intentions are what? Guests that come from Allah to our homes knocking. Open it up. Open up the door. Make them sit. Honor them. Take care of them and follow through. Then you'll see you'll have many more guests coming. So one of our volunteers who listens to our talks regularly here, probably listening right now, I want to share a message he shared with me. His brother, who lives in another state, he mentioned to me yesterday, or day before yesterday, that he had a severe stroke after iftar. And although he said the doctors were able to clear the blockage, alhamdulillah, but he's still suffering a lot of weakness on his left-hand side and semi-vision loss. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this blessed evening, Jum'ah, before iftar, that I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him complete shifa. So Brother Shokat, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him complete shifa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him complete shifa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him strength and give him barakah in his life and his health and accept his good and overlook his faults. So he said that he had spoken to him, this volunteer of ours had spoken to him a few days ago about sponsoring a student. And he said, just yesterday he called him and said, alhamdulillah, I'm doing well and so forth. And he said, yes, I heard your message and I would like to send a portion of my zakat to Darussalam and I'll be mailing the check. So what really touched me was this brother, this volunteer was sharing about his brother. He tells me that he is very prompt and I think he must have mailed a check before he was taken to the hospital. SubhanAllah. That really, really hit me. That, you know, this, and I made dua and I sent a message back. I said, may Allah make all of us like that. That when you make an intention, that you follow through any good deed, because you don't know whether you're going to walk out of your home or you're going to be on a stretcher by nightfall. You don't know if you're going to drive from home or you're going to be driven in an ambulance. So the smart people, when they make good intentions, they don't wait. They don't wait. People say, I want to give in the month. I'm speaking about our fundraisers coming to Sunday for the maintenance. People say, I want to donate in the month of last 10 days. How do you know you're going to make it? How do you know you're going to make it in the last 10 days? Why, at the very least, you write the check or and you send it and you say, okay, and say, please deposit this in the last 10 days. And if I pass away, you deposit it before that. Right? This is what we're speaking about. That hurry up. When it comes to good deeds, we don't delay. We don't delay. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you and I the ability to follow in the footsteps of this brother, and may Allah grant him shifa as well. So today we've discussed one point. What is that? Be deliberate in the situation that seem to demand haste. And especially when it comes to the matter of anger. That's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La taghdab, la taghdab, la taghdab. Okay? That doesn't mean you never become angry. It just means when you're angry, be very careful what you're going to do. Anger is justified at times. But do not do anything while angry that will make you upset later on. Because what is Shaytan's maqsad? To make you upset. Since today is Jum'ah, inshallah, we'll just stop over here so we can have a little bit more time for dua and dhikr, inshallah. One point here, today's concept was deliberation and the balance between deliberating for the matters of dunya and hurrying up in the matters of good deeds. When we do dhikr, dear listeners, make sure we do tahliya and tahliya. La ilaha is tahliya. We're cleaning our heart from any and all evil thoughts and feelings, hatred towards one another, okay? Su'udhan, bad thoughts about one another, or trusting in anyone besides Allah, depending upon anyone else besides Allah, thinking that our needs are going to be fulfilled by anyone besides Allah, all of those thoughts, we remove it from our heart. We remove the cobwebs. We move the cobwebs from the house before we paint it. Similarly, we remove all these cobwebs of the makhluq from our heart, and then we can paint fresh paint, fresh coat of paint of illallah, of the love of Allah, muhabbat of Allah, connection with Allah. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الله 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 الله
Allahu Allah, Allahu Allah, Allahu Allah, Allahu Allah. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أستغفر صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم 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 استغفر الله 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 الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم أنت السلام منك السلام والبركة يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. إن شاء الله we'll make a dua now for 10 minutes and then we can make our own individual dua in our own respective places. Please, if possible, gather our family together all the time. When we're doing collective dua, whether online or your own dua, very, very powerful. Please try to do collective duas at home. As fathers and mothers, I request you to get your children together before iftar and make sure you do every single day a few minutes, inshallah, tabarak wa ta'ala dua. We should not feel shy. If you're feeling shy, then at least just listen to this. And then after that few minutes, we can do our own dua. Also, before I begin my dua, I want to also announce that today being Jumu'ah, many of us would have come and performed Jummah in our own respective masajid, and most definitely we had a habit of donating money when the donation box would be passed, or we would pass by the kiosks or the wall donation boxes. Today, after, again, 7, 8, 9 weeks, Allahu A'lam, I've even lost track of how many Jumas we have not prayed in the masjid. We don't have that opportunity. So if you have not already given some sadaqah today, there's a link here. Just press that and imagine whether it's $1, $5, $100, $500, anything. But before this, the sun of Jum'ah sets, let us inshallah give sadaqah. And as you give sadaqah, please make intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes the difficulty from the world, and Allah opens up our doors of the masajid and madaris and institutions and businesses and everything, and that life can go back to normalcy. And as you make the sadaqah, also make intention for dua for those who are sick, especially Maulana Asif and Maulana Atif, the four ulama, mashallah, who are sibling ulama, brothers of the Glendale Heights community. Their father is in critical condition, and he had a heart attack last night. So please make dua also for his shifa and any others who you may know of who are sick, inshallah. Additionally, tomorrow is going to have an Urdu program. My sheikh and my ustad, inshallah, from Pakistan will be joining at 12 o'clock, Maulana Ubaidullah. So please ensure you are there to listen to his powerful talk and his dhikr that he's going to lead us with. And Brother Khalid Mahmood, that beautiful nasheed artist, inshallah, will be joining us as well. That's 12 o'clock tomorrow. And additionally, lastly, Sunday at 3 p.m. 3 p.m., inshallah, I'll be hosting Maulana Tamim, Dr. Shadi, and Dr. Jawad on a very interesting roundtable discussion, along with our fundraiser for the maintenance of the masjid. So keep all of these announcements in mind. Share with others. There is a link that's going to be posted here for RSVPing. I hope all of you will just simply go for a second and just RSVP to confirm that you'll be coming, to show us the your solidarity, that you are going to be attend that program, and that you are going to invite your entire khandan, family, friends to attend this program on Sunday at 3 p.m. inshallah. Jazakumullah khairah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم اللهم أنت سلام ومنك سلام وتبارك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله اللهم لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك اللهم يا حي يا قيوم سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته اللهم يا حي يا قيوم يا أرحم الراحمين منزول بك كل حاجة اللهم لا إله إلا هو الحليم الكريم سبحان الله رب العرش العظيم والحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والغنيمة من كل بر والسلامة من كل إثم اللهم لا تدع لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا سائلا إلا أعطيته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة هي لك رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا عنتنا ويسرتها لنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الظالمين ونجنا برحمتك من القوم الكافرين ربي اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عما تعلم إنك أنت العز الأكرم ربي اغفر لي وارحمني واعف عني وارزقني ربي اغفر لي ولوالدي ولمن دخل بيتي مؤمنا والمؤمنين والمؤمنات ربي ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا ربي ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين حسبنا الله لما أهمنا حسبنا الله لمن بغى علينا حسبنا الله لمن حسدنا حسبنا الله لمن كادنا بسوء حسبنا الله عند الصراط حسبنا الله عند الميزان حسبنا الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلنا وهو رب العرش العظيم اللهم يا حي يا قيوم رب اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عما تعلم إنك أنت العز الأكرم اللهم يا حي يا قيوم إنا نسألك التقوى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم إنا نسألك التقوى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم إنا نسألك العافية اللهم إنا نسألك دوام العافية اللهم إنا نسألك الشكر على العافية اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اشفهم شفاء كاملا دائما عاجلا مستمرا نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يشفي مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يشفي مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا وشاهدنا وغائبنا
وصغيرنا وكبيرنا وذكرنا وأنثانا. اللهم نحيته منا فأحي على الإسلام، ومن توفيته منا فتوفه على الإيمان. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم واعف عنهم وأدخلهم الجنة. اللهم نقهم من الذنوب كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس. اللهم اجعل قبرهم روضة من رياض الجنة، ولا تجعل حفرة من حفر النار. اللهم لا تحرمنا أجرهم، اللهم لا تحرمنا أجرهم ولا تفتنا بعدهم. اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا وجلاء أحزاننا وذهاب همومنا وغمومنا، وسائقنا إلى جناتك جنات النعيم. Oh Allah, oh Allah, on this blessed Jumu'ah, oh Allah, in the midst of Ramadan, oh Allah, on the evening of right before iftar, Ya Allah, oh, your servants are thirsty, your servants are hungry, your servants are tired. Oh Allah, your servants are, oh Allah, beseeching you and begging you on the day of Jumu'ah before they break their fast. Oh Allah, after having spent the entire day, oh Allah, while fulfilling their obligations, oh Allah, by sending salutations upon you, by performing their salah, oh Allah, by reciting abundant Quran, by doing abundant dhikr, by giving sadaqah, oh Allah, after having done all the good today, oh Allah, all of us, Ya Allah, have gathered here, oh Allah, are with our hands extended in front of you, begging you and beseeching you, Allah, for your mercy, for your Habba, for your love. Oh Allah, we ask you to fill, to enshroud us with your mercy. Oh Allah, through the barakah of your mercy that you're giving us. Oh Allah, oh Allah, oh Allah, I ask you, Allah, to remove the difficulties that we are all facing as an ummah. Oh Allah, we ask you to remove this pandemic. Oh Allah, remove the evil effects of this pandemic. Oh Allah, bring an end to the suffering. Oh Allah, bring an end to the deaths. Oh Allah, bring the end to the lockdowns. Oh Allah, bring the end to people's risk being, Ya Allah, becoming constricted. Oh Allah, bring an end to the various types of difficulties that the ummah is going through. Oh Allah, so many people are sick from the ummah. Oh Allah, whether through this sickness or some other sickness, oh Allah, we ask you to grant shifa to them. Oh Allah, oh Allah, do not allow all the elders and the pious to be lifted from amongst us. Oh Allah, so many pious people, so many righteous and pious people we have heard today. Oh Allah, besides the ones that were mentioned who are sick, oh Allah, we've heard about Allama Khalid Mahmood, one of the most senior ulama of the world. Oh Allah, who was just went in for having fallen down, but now has been told that is in critical condition. Oh Allah, such ulama across the globe, or Ya Allah, we're hearing about them becoming sick, some of them passing away. Oh Allah, we ask you, Allah, do not take these luminaries away from us. Oh Allah, for indeed we will fall into even more darkness. Oh Allah, we have heard from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that a time will come when the pious will be lifted up, when the pious will be lifted up and taken away, and only the most evil people will remain, and their du'as will not be accepted. Oh Allah, and that they will not know the difference between the right and wrong. Oh Allah, please do not put us in that situation. Oh Allah, we ask you, Allah, to allow the pious and the righteous ones to have longer lives. Oh Allah, we need their wisdom, we need their piety, we need their du'as. Oh Allah, we ask you, Allah, do not deprive us of their presence. Oh Allah, we ask you to grant shifa to all those who are sick. Oh Allah, those who passed away today and the previous days. Oh Allah, we ask you to grant them Jannat al-Firdaus. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, before we know it, the Ramadan will end. Oh Allah, already three Jum'ahs have gone. Oh Allah, only two remain. Oh Allah, I ask you, Ya Allah, I beseech you, Ya Allah, that you open up the doors of tawfiq for all of us. Oh Allah, whatever shayateen, whatever nufus, our desires do not allow us to spend half an hour, 45 minutes in front of you making dua on our own. Whatever does not allow us to stand up and pray long tahajjud salah, whatever does not allow us to become more generous, whatever does not allow us to have even better akhlaq and character, oh Allah, oh, allow us to vanquish and destroy those influences. Oh Allah, please, Ya Allah, I ask you, Allah, to cure all of us from those influences, to cure us from the evil that flows through our blood. Oh Allah, that does not allow us to do what we want to do, that does not allow us to achieve what we can achieve, that does not allow us to reach our potential. Ya Allah, we ask you, Ya Allah, to free us from the evil of these shayateen. Free us from the evil attacks of the shayateen. Oh Allah, free us from all sorts of hasad, from all sorts of nadar and evil eye, from all sorts of sihr and black magic. Oh Allah, from all evil effects of shayateen. They're plotting, they're planning against any one of us. Oh Allah, please protect us from the plotting of the shayateen of the humans. Oh Allah, please protect us from the plotting of the shayateen of the humans. Oh Allah, keep us safe from their plots and plans. Oh Allah, we ask you, Allah, protect our families, our loved ones, our spouses, our parents, and our children from the evil effects of shaitan and nafs. Oh Allah, protect all of our masajid, protect all of our madaris, protect all of our dini institutions from the evil effects of shaitan. Oh Allah, we ask you, Allah, protect from all the institutions from infighting, protect them from disunity. Oh Allah, oh Allah, oh Allah, put barakah in their efforts. Oh Allah, grant ikhlas to all the workers of deen. Oh Allah, use them for the service of deen the way you use the sahaba. Oh Allah, we ask you to grant muhabba and love and unite us, O Allah, this group, this group of Darussalam brothers and sisters, O Allah, who listen regularly. O Allah, we ask you, Allah, to grant us muhabba. All of us grant muhabba for one another. Allow us to love one another for your sake. Allow us to love the Prophet ﷺ truly. O Allah, allow us to love you truly. Allow this love that we have for Allah. Allow this love that we have for the Prophet. Allow this love that we have for one another. Allow it to become sincere, and allow it to become a means of us enjoying your throne on the day of judgment. And allow us to become a means of enjoying the shade of your throne on the day of judgment. Ya Allah, we ask you to allow us all to recite Quran abundantly. O Allah, give us the himmah to recite juz after juz after juz. Save us from becoming distracted. Save us from being distracted by shaitan. O Allah, save us from becoming distracted this weekend that is here. O Allah, those who are off, allow, ya Allah, all of us to utilize our time properly. And every moment and every second of Ramadan that is going away, allow us to capitalize on it in ibadat, in khidmat, in learning and in teaching, in dhikr, in dua. O Allah, we ask you, allow these two events of this weekend, these tomorrow's 12 o'clock event and Sunday's 3 p.m. event, O Allah, make them accepted in your sight. O Allah, allow the presence of angels to come. O Allah, all the masjid is empty. O Allah, allow it to become even more populated by angels. Allow it to become even more populated by your invisible creations that are worshipping you. O Allah, although the humans may not be able to come, but ya Allah, these masajid are open to other creations of yours. O Allah, allow these masajid to be ringing with barakah. Allow your creation, especially your angels, to come in our homes. And Allah, our masajid, O Allah, accept these two programs. O Allah, make it a means of our hidayah. Make it a means of our salvation. Make it a means of more and more people coming towards you. Ya Allah, inspire the speakers to say that which we all need to hear, which will become most beneficial for us. O Allah, we ask you that allow these programs to be well attended, and allow hundreds and thousands from across the globe to listen and change their lives. Allow them to attend and listen and change their lives. O Allah, we ask you, Allah, whatever permissible desires and needs the brothers and sisters have, you know the secrets of the heart, you know what's making them worried. O Allah, we ask you to remove their worries. Grant all of us healthy, righteous, pious children. Grant all of us healthy, righteous, pious children. Grant all of us healthy, pious, righteous children. O Allah, grant all of us muhabba and love with their spouses. Grant us the ability to serve our parents and become the source of happiness for them. Those who are not married, O Allah, grant them righteous, pious wives and husbands. O Allah, please, ya Allah, grant them righteous, pious, ya Allah, spouses that will become a good match for them. O Allah, we ask you, those who do not have children, grant them, ya Allah, healthy, righteous children. O Allah, those who are suffering because of sick children or because of disobedient children, O Allah, we ask you to grant them shifa, and allow their children to become, ya Allah, once again, the source of happiness for them. O Allah, we ask you to grant barakah in our sustenance. Grant barakah in our sustenance. Put effect in our sadaqah, in our zakat. Allow us to perform our salah properly. Allow us to give our zakat properly. Allow us to recite Quran properly. Allow us all to make an effort in improving the recitation of the Quran. Allow us all to make an effort to learn ilm. Allow us all to make an effort to improve our character, O Allah, with those who are near us and those who are far away from us. O Allah, we ask you on this blessed day of Jumu'ah, we beg you, Allah, to grant us qubuliyah. Grant us acceptance. Grant us acceptance. Grant us acceptance. O Allah, please, I beg you to forgive all of us, our major and minor sins, O Allah, done by daylight in the darkness of the night, collectively, individually. O Allah, whatever type of sins we have committed, O Allah, insincerity, ya Allah, insincerity, loving anyone more than you, O Allah, fearing anyone more than you, trusting anyone more than you, building our hopes on anyone besides you, ya Allah, all of these sins we have done, O Allah, we ask you, ya Allah, and many, many more we have done, O Allah, save us from becoming despondent. Always allow us to have hope in you. Allow us hope in you, O Allah, we ask you, Allah, ya Allah, have mercy upon the ummah, the Muslim ummah that is distant from masjids, of course, because we're not allowed to, but on top of that, are distant from programs, distant from the Quran, distant from the deen, distant from the discourses of the scholars. Ya Allah, you bring them back. Bring them back. O Allah, any one of us who have relatives who are far away from the deen, O Allah, bring them back. Connect them to your homes, ya Allah. O Allah, have mercy upon them as well. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun, wa salamun ala al-mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ameen, ameen, ameen.